Here we have a Brother 5021 XL 5021 sewing machine. Not working apparently, you can obviously see why. Well neglected, tape everywhere, generally poor condition. So what we need to do is strip it back and have a look, see what the problem is. First thing they're going to do is pull it apart, get down to the bare bones. And then when that's done, we're going to put the covers, give them a bit of a wash. Or just put them to soak at least. Meantime, we're going to have a look at the machine. Like I said, we've stripped it down. As you can see, the bit dry in places. Pinion there, pinion joint, dry, no grease whatsoever. And you can see a lot of thread. A lot of dry oil, dry grease, dust, you know, basic neglect. Shuttle there. A lot of dust and dirt in amongst the needle throat plate housing. That dust there, as you can see, and I'm going to manually rotate it, and as you can see there's like a jerky movement, a lot of dry grease at the bottom there. It's just like a jerky movement, it's not smooth at all. Have a look down at the shuttle, you'll see it's the same thing, it's just jerky, it's not smooth movement. Thread still wrapped around the running gear as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to give it a vac, get rid of the dust and bits of string, you know, stuff like that. Just vac as much as you can and add a little brush some of it out whilst I'm vacing it. Once that's done, clean the unit. I'm gonna get a bit of oil and grease in it. I've got my syringes loaded there, so I've managed to free it off anyway. It's not jerking anymore because I've oiled certain places. So I'm gonna, like I said, add a bit more oil and grease to certain parts that are dry, under the bottom here, below, behind the shuttle mechanism. Bit dry around here, so I'm gonna put a bit of grease around there as well as other places. Bit of movement there. As you can see, I've cleaned the unit as well as vacced it, removed all grease and oil from wherever I can. This is the actual where the actual shuttle sits. Just gonna put a bit of oil around there. Pop the shuttle in. A little bit of oil around that, don't need too much. And just rotate that a couple of times. Also, I'll have a look at the timing, because looks like the timing's out on this one. I'm going to adjust it from, I'm going to adjust the timing from this position to this position. Push the button, computer, ages now. temporarily thread the unit. Just pop the thread spool on top of the bobbin winder temporarily. I'm able to temporarily, as I said, thread the unit so I can try it while it's stripped down. Just gotta feed the needle. Thread through the needle, sorry. I've also inspected the presser foot for damage. Make sure the cables or splits in it or anything like that. Fuse is okay. Clean the pressure foot as well. I'm just gonna pop the bobbin in. Into its housing. Then I'm gonna actually fit the bobbin. Fits in with the shuttle. It pops into its compartment lid. Threaded it. Just pull the thread up from the bobbin. And then I'm going to try and do a stitch, see if it comes okay, see if there's any. I use an envelope here, an old envelope. Just do a little quick stitch, see if it's working, stitching okay. Yeah, it seems to be stitching alright. Try again. Yeah, it's only a short stitch, but there's no drop stitches in that, so it should be okay. Looks okay anyway. Now that the covers have dried, I've washed them, they're dried now. I think I'll start putting the unit back together. Now that the unit is fully assembled, I'm going to do a few tests. Just try and hook up with the stitching programs on a sheet of paper. Just to make sure there's no drop stitches or anything. I'll speed this section up because I cannot stitch this fast, just to speed things up a little. Going through most of the stitch programs. As you can see by this sheet, all tested fine. No drop stitches. And that concludes Job Done.